Pierre Engvall. Into Mikheyev with a little room here. Cuts in front, shoots, Koskinen the save. Rebound, Engvall trying to feed it across. Mikheyev scores! Hey, that's two goals for that line tonight. Kerfoot got the first one. Mikheyev gets this one, 2-0 Toronto.
And you know, it's split-second decisions in the neutral zone. You mentioned not getting the puck deep to get your defense to make a change. It happened once, and then again, Ethan Bear's got a chance to change. Just go. He's pointing at the bench, ends up standing there. Now all of a sudden, he overplays it in the middle. He's tired at the end of a shift, loses his man to the front of the net. Darnell Nurse standing, reaching for the puck. When you're dead tired, your brain doesn't operate quick enough, and Engvall keeps the play alive. A little chip by Kerfoot, and this line, Jim, that we said for Sheldon Keith trying to find a spark, has found it. And for Mikheyev, that's a long time coming. It's been a while for him.
21 games without a goal.
And he gets help there, but that's one that you should have been able to change and bear, if not Nurse, because he was on the left side, should have got off and got a change.
Engvall and Kerfoot will get assists on the goal. Mikheyev's fifth and first in 21. If we get a challenge here, Engvall and Kerfoot will get the assists.
I'm sure if this is a challenge or is there an issue with the ice? Going down to the Zamboni side, so it must be something.
Something's broken in the net, we're told, so they're going to fix that. So there's really nothing to challenge there.
Let's have a look. Did it get hit with the shot? Here's the chip pass.
Oh, yeah, right on it.
Your goal scorer knocked the lights out there as he hit right in the middle, probably broke the protective glass, and yeah, there it was. You can see the glass go flying over Koskinen there, so they got to make sure they get all of it. And they probably don't want any kind of a sharp edge on the camera.
No, so they'll have to get the maintenance people to have a look at that.
You could see the bubble at the other end, the protective covering that is there. A, to protect the camera, which is worth something, but you don't want anybody's face or hands getting in there and getting anything sharp by cutting it.
You see the net where the camera had to be fixed. Is there a cameraman inside there, and can we find out if that camera works? Still a little bit of fixing to do. Tis the season to be streaming. CBC Listen has all your festivities covered with 12 streams of holiday music. Download the CBC Listen app for free now.
It looks to me like the discussion here is, can they just turn the camera around so that there's no issue of it breaking, but also no issue of it cutting anybody? But they haven't been able to get it done as of yet.
Good. There's the picture from the camera now, so it looks like it's working, but it needs some WD-40 and a crescent wrench.
These are the type of matches when you find yourself with a player like McDavid and really only one option on the Edmonton side. You can work your bench and try to manufacture a matchup that'll give you an edge.
Game night is four times a week. Watch Family Feud Canada with host Jerry D. Monday to Thursday. The fun begins this Monday at 8 on CBC and CBC Gem.
All that, and they took the darn thing away.
Yeah.
No net cam now on that end for Koskinen as they finally took it right out of the net.
So we're ready to go again. John Tavares line on for Toronto.